What's up? I go by the name of Chewy Chew, all the way from Lagos, Nigeria, and I'm here to introduce to you Dr. Njakiri.
Welcome to the show. My name is Dr. Damages. We're coming to you from the greatest city in the world,
New York City!
Yes, yes, yes. New York City is so great.
It's great.
That a new law has just been passed.
New law?
In the city council over there. That imposes 15 days in jail and
what?
A fine of $23,000 for publishing fake news.
Fake news?
Or any insult on the mayor of New York City.
Like my man is coming for you.
15 days in jail and $23,000.
Wow. Oh my God.
You see how shocked you were. Psych. It wasn't in New York City. No, no, no. It can't happen here. You know. It was a law passed in Russia.
Russia.
And signed by Vladimir Putin.
Putin!
The Kremlin.
Did you see how it sounded unbelievable,
unbelievable
when I situated the news in New York City?
Mm-hmm.
But the moment I moved it to its proper place, Russia, it became
believable.
Yes.
You know, common place.
Here is how the Russians reacted to the news. Watch. Those are the good old days in Russia. Yeah. Right, by the way, whatever happened to that man?
Vladimir.
No, Boris Yeltsin. Whatever happened to him? You know? Yeah. Guess what?
What?
President Trump is taking notes.
He's taking notes?
You know, if he has his way, he will bring such a law to the United States.
Wow. Yeah.
He will. On today's show, we'll be talking about displacements and replacements.
Exactly.
The easiest way to understand the displacement and replacement is to look at what happened last week at the trade fair complex in Lagos, Nigeria.
Wow.
Take care. They closed down the trade fair complex.
Wow.
Now, there has always been fear and rumor that the Lagos State government wants to take over the trade fair complex owned by the federal government and kick out the traders who were there.
Exactly.
Kick them out,
Now, I dismiss some rats.
The fear feeds on the rumor, and the rumor feeds on the fear.
Sasha!
So when the market was closed, the traders protested.
They protested.
Take a look.
We are in a foolish country, Nigeria.
Mm-hmm.
A stupid country. Country without law.
Mm-hmm.
Country who don't know the value of human being.
You see,
beyond the protest,
uh-huh.
Here is what such fear and rumor leads to. Take a look.
The only message I'm trying to give our Igbos in Nigeria, the Biafran Igbos, is for them to organize themselves. Since this land, they reject us as one Nigeria, then the best thing for us to plan ourselves to live in this country and have our own country. They're called Biafran land.
Ah!
You see what I'm saying? That's what I'm talking about. You know,
yes.
About fear of displacement. Exactly. You got it. Now, that is scary as it is. Well, the displacement and the replacement that I want to talk about today is wider and deeper. So bear with me.
Stop.
Last week, a 28-year-old Australian man
28?
Opened fire in two mosques in Christchurch, New Zealand, killing 51 people.
This is sad.
In 74-page manifesto, the man complained that immigrants are displacing white people in Australia, in New Zealand, in Europe, and in America.
Wow.
He called it the great displacement. You might as well say it's the great replacement. I'm sure that terrorist never paused to ask the Aborigines of Australia or the Native American Indians of North America what they think of white people coming into
them.
Their own land, taking them over and calling them their own land. You know what? Watch one of them.
People celebrating the day that your people got slaughtered and invaded, and the day that caused all that destruction and all that suffering to very peaceful people.
Ah! He missed the history.
So this young terrorist from Australia moved to New Zealand after his father died and left a lot of money for him. Mm-hmm. Initially, people don't know this. Initially, he didn't know what to do with the money. Oh, at first, he said he just wanted to play video games, snort cocaine, and hire strippers to cook for him. Oh. Strippers, do they cook?
I wonder.
I mean, I didn't know that. In all my experiences with strippers.
What?
Sorry. Too much information. Where was I? Sorry. So this is a serious issue. How I wish the terrorists followed this initial plan of just playing video games,
yes,
snorting cocaine, and hiring strippers to clean his room. I mean, things would have been okay, you know? Along the way, he decided to travel around the world with the father's money. While traveling around the world, he became interested in white supremacist ideas. You know, white supremacy is the idea that white people are superior to other races.
Trumpy idea.
And are in this world to subdue, dominate, and take dominion over all things.
What?
I wonder where they got that idea. Genesis 1:26. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
1:20.
Now, one of the white supremacist ideas is that there is a great genocide against white people.
What?
By black people.
What?
Muslims. Jews. What? Latinos. What? Who are determined to take over white people's countries like America,
what?
Australia, New Zealand, and what? All the countries of Western Europe. I know.
What?
I know. History. To which Native Americans, Indians, and the Aborigines, they all said, excuse me?
Who is accusing
who? Yeah, exactly. You know, whenever I hear people fighting about who owns the land, I know that they do not understand. They don't understand.
They have like,
the truth of the matter is that the land owns us.
The land owns all of us. Yes.
Unless your body is turned into ashes in a bonfire,
yes,
you will end up inside the ground.
Of course, dust to dust.
Come on, my brother, talk to him.
See, my people see land ownership as being totally different to the English way of ownership, because ours used to be, really, the land owns us, and it still is that to us.
I'm just trying to give people background.
Yes.
Oh, by the way, this terrorist said that President Trump was a symbol of white identity, and that he was also the one that inspired him.
Yes.
Something like that. Did you say why?
Why?
For bringing back white pride. That's what he said.
White pride.
Why? I know.
White supremacy.
White pride. I bet you there are some bikers out there singing that great song.
What?
Holy, 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 Donald J. Trump is a white savior. Holy, 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 Donald J. Trump is a white savior. Holy, holy. I mean, there are people singing that song now everywhere. He's the white savior. I didn't know that. That Australian personal trainer turned terrorist had hoped that his shooting of Muslims in New Zealand will start a civil war in America.
Got it wrong.
A war that will separate white people from black people.
He got it
and
wrong.
Bring an end to the melting pot idea.
He got it wrong.
I wonder what Trump thinks about that. Let's look up.
Who's the one that said that?
you know, this is their consequences. Anyway, out of fear and a sense of worthlessness, a common feature in men with low self-esteem, this man took three guns, went into two mosques, and killed 51 people. It is the same. He was going to go to the third one. Yes. It is the same fear and low self-esteem that is causing the killings in other parts of the world. Be it 9/11 attack, the radical Islamists who ram trucks into people in Europe, the white supremacists who went to a church in North Carolina and killed 9 people.
Yes.
The Fulani herdsmen who attack communities in the middle belt of Nigeria.
Farmers.
And the killings in Southern Kaduna. It is the same thing.
Exactly.
It doesn't matter. It is the same
irrational
fear.
Unjustified fear.
Funny enough, no group in the history of mankind has killed their way to permanent greatness.
Ain't gonna happen.
Permanent greatness. No. Eventually, he who kills with the gun.
Yes.
Falls to the gun.
So shall it be.
This this is how it happens. You know, with time, the one that you are suppressing, keeping down with a knife or a gun, will get his hand or her hand on a sharper knife or a bigger gun and turn the table around.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm preaching today.
Preach it!
I'm preaching.
Preach it!
More importantly, have you noticed that replacement and displacement depends on time and location?
Yes, exactly.
Physics.
No, look at it. Look at it. Those who fear displacement today are often those who caused displacement 400 years ago.
Exactly.
You know that?
What goes around comes around.
Yeah. Those who have been displaced in one location today are often those displacing other people in another location.
Location.
History is going to repeat.
Life is like that.
It's just like that.
Life is not fair.
Wow.
Okay, life is not fair.
It's not fair.
I know Generally. That I just spent 5 minutes talking about Muslims killed in New Zealand. Since January of this year, over 200 people have been killed in Zamfara State, Nigeria. By people called bandits. In Southern Kaduna, over 200 people have been killed.
Yes.
It's not making news anyway.
This year alone.
The world doesn't care.
Too many of them.
They don't care.
Too many.
Anyway, forget these sad stories. Forget these sad stories. Let's talk about beautiful things. There's a village in Ghana called Mafido Village.
Mafido
You know the village?
I know,
the only village in the world where nobody who lives there was born there.
What?
Yep. You can do things in the other room. But when it's time to give birth to that baby, you have to go to another town.
Yes.
Wow.
Women are not allowed to give birth in that town.
What?
Is it it's a considered a taboo against the gods. I know. You don't want to offend the gods, you?
Yeah, I know. Exactly.
How dare you? To be fair to the elders, nobody is also allowed to be buried in that town.
Hey!
You are not born, you are born somewhere else and you are buried somewhere else.
Hey!
How do you get citizenship of that town?
I don't know.
Wow. Isn't that wonderful? Now, the elders said that the voice came from heaven and gave that instruction to their forefathers when they first arrived at that town.
No man's land.
Watch.
Gbedidicho jifo vane. Bi anyi gba ki eji na ovale giela. Enye bi obi anogi ela. Kolenti. Sike anyi gba medie. Anyi gba koko e wonya. Eko ma enye opo ma jivile giyo. Opo ma anyela. Na meku.
we don't make this sense up.
Yes.
No, but is it me or do you feel that elders of today are young people?
I don't know. It is
young. Does that one count as an elder?
No, I mean, it doesn't fall into that category.
Anyway, now one feminist wants to change all that.
He wants to change it.
Watch.
That's me. I go in me. Bank to allow the food. I don't make both full again. Can't shop. Can't talk. On how I make both. My coach to allow the food. No pa. Can't feel my vagina like that. Can't have a dope. Can't have a Can't turn your mouth. Very new. Can't clinic. Can't have a vagina. Can't. But then my own. Clinic. No. Get my. It turn your my vagina.
Okay. You got me. All right. She's not a family. She's just a woman. Pregnant woman. Who is tired of going out of town to have a baby.
After how many kids?
After 2 kids, this is the third one. She's tired of running out of town. You are in labor and you have to run, get a vehicle because you can't have baby in your own town.
Yes, imagine.
Africans and fear. I say give birth and let's see what the God will do.
Exactly.
What would they do?
I wonder.
Bring forth bees to attack you.
Yes.
Try it.
Yes, try it.
Try it for the sake of the children.
Our case cannot be
You don't want to offend the God.
Say that I sent you. Try it.
Don't want to offend the gods of people.
Anyway, talking about children and their future.
Children and their future.
Yeah.
Their education.
Yeah. Here is a story that captures the real situation of things in Nigeria. Last week, the federal government of Nigeria, you know, they are very powerful. They stated
next
that
level.
It would it will start jailing parents who fail to send their children to school. Look at the headline now.
Wow.
They will jail people who fail to send their
starting from where?
Starting from next week. Now, that was how Atiku went to school, by the way.
Yes.
You guys know that?
Exactly.
The colonial masters threatened to send Atiku's father to jail.
Yes.
Unless he sent Atiku to school.
Exactly.
So they can have
his father pulled Atiku from the farm and sent him to school.
Hey.
You know. Never mind that he didn't go far. That's a story for another day.
He has YAC.
That's it. The other one we don't want
to worry. At least he has YAC.
But But looking at the number of kids out of school in Nigeria, I doubt if they have enough prisons to accommodate the parents. You know what I mean?
Over 30 million kids.
Anyway, here is a story that illustrates the irony. In Delta State of Nigeria,
yes.
A 7-year-old pupil of Okotiebo Primary School named Success. She went to school.
Yes.
One day, she was sent home for not paying her school fees. Now, on her way home, someone stopped her and asked her questions. Take a look.
You never pay now?
I never been on the channel, no go pill. I'm gonna push you back later on the frog, but I'm gonna push you back.
Okay, so you wait, but you better not meet a flog, you all better send me, you go tell your mom.
Flog me, flog me.
Why they go flog me?
That will be flog. The cannon go tired, they go tired for flogging. They go flog, 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 they go tired. And they say they stop, but they say I saw my body.
I know. The kid said that she will pay her school fees when her parents get the money. But if the school teachers prefer to cane her, that they will be the ones tired of caning her. She said that if the teachers thought they were stubborn about stopping her from going to school, that she would show them that she was more stubborn than they are.
Yes!
As expected, the video went viral. A lot of Nigerians came out to pledge their support for the girl.
Yes.
Watch.
They go flog, they go tired, don't worry, they don't flog you again, yeah?
So many people offered to pay her school fees.
Now,
very few of those offering to pay her school fees, apparently, they don't look out of their windows, car windows, that tinted windows, when they are driving around Nigeria. You know? Because if they had, they would have seen girls like her all over Nigeria. Girls and boys like her all over Nigeria. And they would have done something. Just hold that thought. Just take a look.
So the building is in need of
collapse. Need to build now. The first step will collapse and should they lay the under.
Okay.
Maybe they're going to fall the entire inside. Maybe they're not good.
Okay, and my building just collapsed in Lagos 2 days ago too.
Wow.
Yep, that is the state of the school that is sending these students home for not paying school fees.
Look at
the school. Shouldn't that school be refunding the money?
This is pathetic.
Shouldn't that school be refunding the money that these kids pay?
I know. Yeah.
To attend that
school. This is public school for God's sake.
Anyway, the moment Success story went viral, the governor of the state, he woke up. Also got involved. I heard that they suspended the teacher who flogged her.
Wow.
And now they are renovating the school.
I said
this. Yeah, whitewash.
Said
nonsense, whitewash. This is what I think. All states and local governments in Nigeria should do is just to declare national educational emergency.
Yes, exactly.
Let all governors and local government chairmen or women pay visits to all primary and secondary schools in their states. All public schools in their domain.
Yes.
And see what is needed. Then mobilize the public and private sector to uplift education in Nigeria. Anything else is just fluff.
Fluff.
I say fluff on the part of the government and on the part of the people showing concern. Now, for the people, the best way to show your concern is to hold the government accountable.
Yes.
On each day on every matter.
Oh yeah.
Not to wait until a video is viral.
Yeah, I know.
The embarrassing video. Then you wake up. Yes, let me talk to Success. I will take care of
that.
Nonsense. Like Success said, if they say they're stubborn, we the people, we go show them say we're stubborn.
So we pass them.
They go tired.
This is something we call This American Life Set.
Yes.
Have you seen that? It's a new or brand new
that
segment.
Book.
The brand new segment, This
Did
American
you read
Life.
The book?
I don't know. Have you read the book?
Yes, I read it.
Most Africans in America do not understand, abroad, not just in America, do not understand what we mean when we say your village people are after you.
Yes.
They don't understand
that. They follow you.
We have a video that illustrated that. The power of the village people.
Yes.
Take a look. saying? Hey, there are a lot of people in New York today that behave this way. It's village people. It's not, it's not their fault. It's not their fault. It's not their fault. Village people. This one is a new segment we call Just the Facts. We don't add anything. Just the facts. We just present it to you, make you think.
Make your judgment. Your
judgment, just think. Now, the internally generated revenue of Lagos State in 2016 was 301.99 billion.
Hey!
What?
That is more than the revenue generated in 33 states of Nigeria.
Hey!
With the exclusion of Ogun and Delta and River State.
What?
The rest of the states, they come up with 299 billion.
What have they got to
just think
for it?
Just think about it. Think about
what
it.
Have they got
exactly, to exactly. When you think about Ambode and the wonders you think he's doing, just think about how much
what
money.
What have they got to show for it?
Just think about that. This is something we call Secrets of
Pictures.
It's better than the premise that a picture is worth more than 1,000
words.
No. The picture you're looking at is the picture of the Kano State governor.
Ganduje.
He was carrying a head pan at a construction site in an effort to win votes for the upcoming supplementary election. Look at him. Look at him. This is a man that pockets $5 million in his pocket. I'll tell you this. I don't think this is not what Malcolm X meant when he said by any means necessary. You know, because that's what the man is doing by trying to win election by any means necessary, including carrying
nonsense.
Here are some stories making headline news across Nigerian newspapers this week.
Hi, I'm Dr. Damages. Do high fees damage your wallet when you send money home? I've got the damage control. Use Wave for no fee transfers. Remember the promo code Doctor for $5.
Oh, okay. This is wonderful. Atiku asks Tribunal to sack Buhari and declare him winner.
Winner! Why not?
you know, I'm sure that he must have hacked into INEC server. The issue is not, he must have evidence for why they should sack Buhari. Uh-huh. The problem is not about sacking Buhari.
Yes.
It's what the tribunal will do after that. Where will they run to?
Yes.
Take it back.
I mean, where will they run to? The tribunal. After you declare Buhari, you are sacked.
They will take it back.
Nigeria. This one blew the internet. Buhari, perhaps even poorer now than he was in 2015.
Who said that?
Says the vice president.
Hey, professor. The poor man mentality.
You know he doesn't lie. He's a prophet and pastor and professor.
That's why we're where we were.
But I have a question for him. By the way, we have always meant to ask this question to the man of God.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the vice president, how much does Buhari take home every month as security vote? Because we hear about governors taking home. Can you tell us?
Yet
he's still poor.
That's why we're
how much?
That's where we're
and his cows are still the same.
What? Yeah, his cows are always 150. How much does he take home? Just help us.
Tell us. Prof.
You know, son.
As a big prophet. Lawyer,
tell us, man of
no
God.
No profit, no loss.
You know, are we going to celebrate that he's poorer now? You know? Is he spending money feeding his family in the Nazareth? No. We spend the money now. Newspapers that he read, we pay for that.
Mm-hmm. All the jetting
as well. We pay for that.
Yes.
Why should he be poorer?
We're in trouble.
If he can,
Nigeria
is a messed up place. Then, if he can manage his own,
that's why we're where we are.
Anyway, next. Oh, this is good. Gwenga Daniels fires back.
Okay,
he says nobody should insult me.
Not insult
for
me.
Dumping PDP.
What?
The man was penciled down to be the secretary to the federal government by Atiku. You know. Aren't we lucky that Atiku didn't make it? Because can you imagine this kind of character being secretary to the federal government?
Imagine that.
He abandoned Atiku even before the final result is announced.
No principle, no ideology.
Abandoned him, you know?
He said he didn't abandon him.
He abandoned him. What? Why can't he wait until the court rules?
2 weeks after.
Atiku has his own list of ministers he's putting down now.
He's the man from PDP.
Yeah. Yeah, but if you abandon the people, you run away from PDP, where Atiku is. How can you be the secretary to the federal government?
Nonsense.
We have you penciled down for that position.
Yeah. Nonsense.
It's Juju that is after him. I know that. The man loves Juju.
Yes.
Just that's it. Anyway. Come next. On. Oh, this is good. Bandits in Zamfara are better equipped than the military. Cries Governor Yari.
What?
You know the guy, governor of the state. I said, if you cry to us, what are we supposed to do? The defense minister is from your state. Speak your language to the man now.
Yes.
Why are you crying to us?
Cry
that
to
the,
me.
The bandits are more better equipped than the military.
With the people are helpless.
What are we gonna do? I don't have a gun. Do you have a gun?
No,
help this man? Talk to your minister now.
States.
Nonsense. And what are you doing with your security board, by the way? What is he doing with his man? He's never in the state anyway. He's always in Abuja and in Saudi Arabia. Praying. That's not the solution. Do something. Stop praying. Do something.
He cried. He cried to the federal government.
Crying to the federal government. Crying to us.
Crocodile
tears. No, nonsense. Anyway. Oh, this is wonderful. I won't influence INEC to change election results for APC governors, says Buhari. Wait a minute. Is he saying that he has the ability to do it? Get out of here, man! How often has the man been doing that?
Have you done that?
He must have done that before.
He won't do the usual.
You see, this is what I'm saying, you know, having this kind of president. He didn't think about what is the implication of what
so
he's saying.
Doing it before.
He will just say something and then the people will be like, what?
Of course.
Anyway, it's time for your
emails!
It's time for your email. Agege Bread, welcome back.
Thank you.
How are you doing?
Agege Bread.
Something, you know, this happened.
She has gone wings.
It's close. It's close. There's a plan. There's something. There's something. It's coming. This week. Yeah, this summer. Yeah, because this summer.
Don't look for your pocket. Yeah. Well, anyways.
This week, it's in bad news, you know. We hope that next
bad
week there will be good news. So that we have reasons to smile. Just to be, you know, we don't do this for tragedy. We do this as supposed to be coming.
We are supposed to have fun with it.
Yeah. Anyway. So, do we have emails today?
Every day, doctor.
Okay, let's hear them, please.
So, our first email is from Badejo.
Badejo. I know him.
Badejo.
Where?
In Nigerian, in Guangzhou.
Guangzhou.
Aha! Yes! China.
I remember.
China, you know, it's our friend. Aha. Mm-hmm. What does he want?
And he writes.
Yes.
Hello, Dr. Damages.
Yes, my man.
I'm a big fan of your show.
Mm-hmm.
I have one question for you.
Okay. Uh-huh.
What is the name of that Yoseto school?
Hammer scope. You want to see what happens?
Noise your noise maker.
Noise maker, come. Let's see. Hammer scope. He's still. No more heart attack.
Thank you.
For another 5 years. Okay, what else? This is wonderful.
And I think you can use it to raise the dead, like the Ethiopian.
I don't know about that one. We've not tried it. We've not tried it. We start from small
miracles. Common sense.
That, like the one we did now. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. My regards to your beautiful Agege
friend. I see. Thank you, my friend. Thank you so much. You are not the only one. That's the problem. You know.
Keep trying.
You know.
Now we know.
They are bishops. They are, you know, archbishops. I heard that they are archbishops now.
Governors.
Governor. He wants us to show the picture. There was a picture. With some governors and ex governors and future governors. Yeah. Anyway, she's moving up. People just write email thinking that you don't know she's up there. Next.
Our second email is from Martins in New York.
Brooklyn. He lives in Brooklyn. Down there. Just $1.50 you get. $1.50, I know his house.
Hi, doctor. Uh-huh. This is your friend Martins from New York.
We know, thank
New
you.
York. I sent you a message a few weeks ago, but you guys refused to read it.
Why?
Does he know why?
Anyways, I know why the message was ignored. Why was it ignored?
I don't know.
Okay. I'm wondering now. He said, please, Please, I want to ask you a question.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Why is it that whenever Adeola, Keeping It Real, posts a video, she usually gets 200 or more thumbs down? Does it mean people don't want her video anymore or what? Unlike you, you get a few thumbs down, which indicates that people are really enjoying your show.
Hmm.
Kindly explain to me, please, why we haven't heard from Shore.
Mm-hmm.
Is he going to court for his own mandate stolen from the federal government?
Mm-hmm.
Or has he accepted defeat?
You know, I don't have an answer to that. But the one that bothered me was, it's AAC.
Yes.
They were leading in River State.
Yes,
and
yes.
Then they went to court to stop them from announcing the results.
Yes.
Uh-huh. I don't understand. They don't want to win. They don't want to win anymore because they were leading. Yes. And I was thinking they would let them announce the result and announce, you know, even if it's for 2 days, the governor from AAC. But then they now went to court and said, stop that. We'll bring you later and you will talk about that.
Next.
And he saw him parading polling booths during the governorship
with
election.
With a coffee in hand.
Say yes.
Are you sure it's coffee?
Are you sure it's coffee?
It's not coffee, you know, governor. What's his name? Not Remy Martins. What's the name of that one? The red one.
Campari.
It's Campari. Next, go, guys.
Coffee.
Yeah, coffee. All right. What's the next one? Yeah.
Okay, so our final email is from Emeka Uzoechina.
Emeka Uzoechina. From where?
I don't know where this one is from.
Yeah, we don't know.
And he writes,
okay, let's see what
from Abia.
I am a strong fan of your show.
Wow, good.
And always intellectually hilarious.
We try.
Please tell Agege Bread that I like her hips.
The problem is this is the problem I have with the guy. He doesn't know there are bishops, archbishops, and people governors, new governors. No, I don't know the chances you have. Tell us more about yourself, your bank account. I mean, good luck to you, and talk to me in private.
Good luck to you if you want.
Yes, talk to me in private.
Yes.
We can talk, you know.
She has to come through.
Through the noisemaker. Next! Next!
That's all we have for today.
I'm just getting fired up, you know. Anyway, that's all the time we have for emails. Please keep sending your emails to
drdamages@gmail.com.
And follow us on Twitter at
drdamages.
And on Instagram at
drdamages.
And here's my concern for today.
Uh-huh.
It's taken from page 419 of the book Love, Love, Love.
Love by
Thomas Melton.
Mm-hmm.
And it says, our job is to love others without stopping to inquire whether or not they are worthy. This is for the terrorists. I'm just telling you. This is for people who hate other people. Love others without stopping to inquire whether they are worthy. Until next week, I'm Dr. Damages. I diagnose
you yourself.
So, doctor, do you love me?
Yeah, of course. My noisemaker. Come. Of course. All of you, all of my people.
Thank you.
Noisemaker.
Thank you for that. Explain to us.
Yes. Why is AAC running away from? They're about to win the River State governorship election.
But,
even though people don't know who the candidate is.
But they are using.
Now they went to court.
Yes.
To stop the INEC from announcing
the
for
that. The incumbent governor is using instrument of states to outpower AAC candidate in River State. We shall go to the court and stop all their shenanigans.
Hey!
Well, taking me!
this is the nice worker himself. You know?
I have a question.
Okay, go ahead.
There's a new segment.
One day I sit down and take questions from people. Yeah,
I know,
go ahead.
There's a new segment, it's American Life.
This American Life. Oh, yeah. It's every week now because people don't know what people go through in this America. So we have to. There are people you see here. There's one guy. You know what? One guy from MB said who is homeless after 35 years
in America.
Next week we'll tell you about him in this American Life. Because you need to be hearing about life of your people.
The ones in the village.
What are you trying to tell us? How much you pay Mamun Doka for her to be able to give you your paper?
No, we don't have that.
Yes.
Everything. We don't hide anything.
Yes, you're open.
We're open.
Facts,
you know?
By itself.
Yeah, so that you know before you start coming here.
Yes.
Because Trump is
beyond the green of
Trump.
Pay.
Trump doesn't.
Don't worry.
You know? Just watch. With everything, we'll show you everything.